Frequent users of Final Cut Pro know how valuable compound clips are, but the very essence of their nature, that's to combine all selected clips into one entity, can be a pain to understand. And this is especially so when you're creating a compound clip as a template that you intend to use over and over in future projects and those that contain title clips. When you change the words in a title, they change in all other places that you've used the template. And I'll show you two ways of solving this issue. I'll also give you some tips about compound clips at the end of the tutorial. And if you've got topics that you'd like covered, let me know in the comments below. I'm Bruce McBride, and I can provide one-on-one personal tuition over the internet. Just click trainingfinalcutpro.com. Now let's get right into it. For this exercise, I'm going to make a template that I've made into a compound clip as an opener for my YouTube videos. Here's a video opener that I've used previously. I've now decided to make it into a template for future YouTube videos. I'll create a compound clip out of this. I'll select the three title clips, right-click and select a compound clip. And we'll call that YouTube opener. Now select which event you want it in. It creates a new video clip in the browser with the compound logo in the left corner. Now to create a new independent opener, you have two choices. And let me say, this first one is my preferred method, as it's more obvious which is the original compound. You can select the compound in the browser under the Edit menu, Duplicate. That's Command plus D. An independent copy is created. The clip with the orange underline is the original, and it's still in the timeline. Select the copy and change the name. The second method is to select the compound in the timeline and select Reference New Parent Clip under the Clip menu. An independent copy is created in the browser. This time, the copy is the clip in the timeline. It has the orange underline in the thumbnail. And be careful which one you change the name of. Let's see what happens when we change something in the original. I'll drag the original compound into the timeline again to show what happens when I change some text. I'll double-click the new version and change the word secrets of to changed. And for good measure, I'll change the colour to red. Now let's look at the original clip. It's also been changed. I'll undo these changes so the original is back to what it was. This time, I'll drag the copy and make those changes. I'll double-click and change the word secrets of to changed, and for good measure, change the colour to red again. Now let's check the original, and you can see that the changes in the copy have not affected that original. Did you know you could create an empty compound that you can add components to at a later date? Select an event in the black area of the browser, right-click and select New Compound Clip. The first method we use to create a compound clip from the timeline uses the settings from the timeline. This new compound clip allows you to make your own settings. Double-click the thumbnail to open it in the timeline. Drag your clips in as required. And finally, a tip on how to break apart a compound clip in your timeline. You can, of course, double-click the compound clip and it will open as a semi-project in the timeline. You could, if you wanted to, copy those components in the compound clip and paste them into any project elsewhere. Then you could use the left previous arrow to go back to the project containing the compound clip. Or, if you no longer want the compound clip, you could select it in a project and under the clip menu select Break Apart Clip Items. That's Shift plus Command plus G. And you'll see that it's broken apart. And the interesting thing about this is that the compound clip that's stored in your event browser stays in place to be used later. Oh, and one more thing. Of course, you can make duplicates of any clip in the event browser. Command plus D.
Let me know in the comments below if you've got some areas that you struggle with in Final Cut.
I'd be happy to produce a video to solve those issues. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and press the bell. There are new videos every Sunday.